rise and shine, Mr. Sandgroper. Rise and shine. Not that I wish to imply you've been shirking your duty. No one is more deserving of a rest, and the entire Perth train lines would all be to waste if it wasn't for East Perth. But now, your time has come again, dear Sandgroper. Time you learnt about Alex McConnell.
That's right, we're going to Frio, yo. Yeah, you best be walking, fam. I'ma f***ing screw you up. Gonna need more than the Frio doctor when I'm done with you, cause we in Fremantle, yo. It's not how Fremantle people sound like. And, I don't know why I have this jumper. I'm a West Coast supporter. But still, we in Frio now. That's right, guys. Today's little history lesson comes from the wonderful place called South Fremantle, and it's more of a Western Australia-wide history lesson, but South Fremantle's involved somehow, don't worry. Today's video is about Alex McCallum, who was a Western Australian politician that represented South Fremantle and was born on the 28th of October, 1877.
Did you ever hear the tragedy of Alex McCallum the Musso?
What the hell? Oh, sorry, I didn't know this toilet was occupied.
I thought not. It's not a story the West Australian would tell you. It's a Labour legend.
What are you going on about?
Alex McCallum was a politician of the unions. So serious and so energetic, he could use the government to influence the administrators to extend sewage schemes. He had such a knowledge of the government that he could even keep the electorate he cared about from dying.
Wish I could fix my sewage system like that.
The Labour side of the government is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural. He became so powerful, the only thing he was afraid of was losing his life. Which eventually, of course, he did. Unfortunately, he caught his kidneys nymphitis, destroying his lymphatic nodes and dying. Ironic. He could save others from sewage failure, but not himself.
Sorry, sir. I don't feel so good.
This man was a fucking badass, which I can say objectively as he died from chronic nephritis which damaged his body's sewer system. McCallum was what people called a radical politician back when radical meant less about being a vegan and more about continuously haggling the government non-stop about their financial management until the opposition starts crying and gets an allergic fever towards any form of counting implement, including those 1 centimeter deci blocks we played with in year 2 and 3. People used to call him Musso after the World War II dictator of Italy, Mussolini. This dude was made the Minister for Public Works, Labour, Water Supply and State Trading Concerns. Old mate had so many jobs, he basically became the Johnny Sins of Western Australian politics. His achievements included establishing the headquarters of the Labour movement, organising many of the previously unorganised workers in the state, drafting the arbitration court, and winning so many awards and agreements in workers' favour that he was called the best hated man by employers, who upon seeing an image of him would promptly hiss and slither away like the snake in their 1930s top hats and briefcases. Mind you, looking at an image of him was probably the equivalent of looking at the image of
SCP-096.
The last thing employers would see after seeing an image of him was him just walking up in a f***ing 1930s top hat at f***ing Mach 1 speed. Oh, did you get me an image? How bad of you?
Where's the 44-hour work week, Tina?
This man, not as some glorious leader of the nation, but as a simple minister. had contributed major, long-lasting change to this nation, extending sewerage systems at a time where the entire country was struggling to stay afloat during the 1930s. Basically being the roadie to who was the premier at the time, Philip Collier. Dying in 1937 was a great loss to this state, as this man contributed so much. I assume it was the 1930s, most of what he was saying didn't really make sense because they were speaking in terms I really couldn't understand, but I assume he was a great contribution to the state. I wish I could write more about him in this video, I just wish I had more time.
Time, Mr. Sandgroper. Is it really that time again? It feels like it has been less than 5 minutes since we've last talked. It is quite a history that I have provided here, as Musso, McCallum. But I'm afraid I may have overstayed my welcome to you. I feel like I need to liberate you from your time, and besides, this is where I get off.